Netherlands, Belarus, Romania, Germany, United States of America, Italy, attention.
Watching this one is Paul, over to you.
Well, this final of the women's quad scowls has just got underway. Germany, the title holders from last year, they're back on the course with a new crew. We've seen Germany, the United States and Italy already all win gold in other events here today. Which of these crews can repeat that for their nations here now in the women's quad scowls? The fastest away off the blocks, undoubtedly Germany. That lineup of Keutzer, Kohl, Schulz and Brockmann, with two veterans of WRJC returning, including last year's bronze medalist in the double, Shirin Brockmann, who takes over the heavy responsibility of stroking this crew potentially to victory. So she sits in the stern, sets the rhythm, and in German the word for the stroke woman is the Schlagfrau, because she sets the Schlag, the stroke, as it hits the water every time, and sets the rhythm for that crew. Now, going best with the Germans at this early stage is Italy, currently lying in second place. A potential birthday present for two of their crew. One of their crew turned 16 on Monday, another turned 18 in this week of preparation and racing here at Eton on the 3rd of August. But going with them well at the moment, the Dutch lineup from Leiden and Zwolle, that combination that includes Hannah Fischer, whose big sister won bronze and silver in the Dutch silver, the Dutch senior eight in recent years. She classically rose in gloves. She's doing that again this year. Suffers, like a lot of oarsmen and women, from serious blisters, but fairly blistering pace being set at the moment at the head of the field by the Germans in particular. It's really looking very good, as it's done all through the competition. They've found plenty of swing from early on. The boat's running on nicely. It's got that slightly unusual Viking prow type bow, rather than the longer, more drawn out type, and a slightly stubby nose at the front of the boat, but absolutely nothing stubby about this approach to this race. They're looking very good. They've got lots of run on the boat. It's good controlled aggression, and at 750 meters they've already found clear water, so they're repeating, if you like, what their male colleagues have just done in the four, by going out early, taking the race by storm and staying out in front. Well, if that picture remains unchanged, the big question for us is, of course, where do we focus for silver and bronze? Showing best at the moment, it's still the Italians. They've stroked by Cecilia Bellassi. A heavy responsibility at stroking any crew, but she knows what it feels like to win a B final, at least in WRJC, in the quad last year, has already bettered that performance by making it here to the A final, and may well be on track for a medal. Romania, a strong tradition of women's rowing, proving that again by moving into second place at just short of 1,000 metres. And just behind them, the Netherlands. Still a very close race for all those positions, apart from first, the Germans going out in a class of their own at the halfway stage. Fantastische Leistung von Franziska Kreuzer, Annemarie Kroll, Bonner Schulz und Shirin Brockmann, der letztjährigen Bronzemedaille-Gewinnerin im Doppelzweier. Dieser Doppelvierer führt jetzt das A-Finale souverän mal an. Die haben ab dem ersten Schlag ihrer Dominanz unterstrichen, sehr schnell dann freies Wasser hinter sich, dann zwischen ihnen und den Holländerinnen, den Rumäninnen und den Italienerinnen abgesetzt. Eine ganze Flottille, eine Armada an Trainern auf beiden Seiten auf ihren Fahrrädern. Ich schätze die persönliche Betreuungsverhältnisse hier auf ungefähr 5 Radfahrer pro Frau. Es ist ja unglaublich, wie viele Leute dann plötzlich hier überall herum Radfahren dürfen. Aber wen juckt es nach 1250 Metern? Der Frauen-Doppelvierer des Deutschen Ruderverbandes, da wird sich Siegfried Keibel mal freuen. Er ist heute hier auf der Tribüne, der Präsident des Verbandes. Enttäuschende Blicke natürlich nach Beijing, jetzt aber sehr positive Richtung London. Nächstes Jahr hier auf eben dieser Wasserstrecke. Fantastische Leistung, wirklich eine Klasse für sich, muss man ganz klar sagen, das deutsche Boot. Dann aber die Rumäninnen, die sind gut auf Medaillenkurs Richtung Silber. Und hinter ihnen, das Feld noch weit, weit offen, es ist sehr, sehr eng. Well, happy days for the president of the German Rowing Federation, Siegfried Keitel, is here this weekend to cheer on his crew's bitter disappointment after Beijing. now looking forward to London with great optimism, and here, with this kind of crew, are able to look to Rio with some kind of optimism as well, because the German four, the quad that's moving now towards 1,500 metres, is way out on its own. Absolutely a class of its own. The Romanians, the best of the pack that's following them, starting to move out to something that looks like a more of a lead ahead of the United States and the Netherlands. They're neck and neck for third at the moment at 1,500, but they're several lanes apart, can't really see each other terribly easily. The Belarusian lineup still very much in the picture as well. Italy, who looked good early on, they've hit a bit of a wall between 1,000 and 1,500, slipped back now into sixth place. But still in the bronze and silver slots, the field wide, wide open. There's still really anyone medals for taking over the last quarter. Just over 250 metres to go, though, at the head of the field. And still tanking along, great flowing rhythm, plenty of attack. Time, though, to reflect on the slide. They're not letting up the pressure at all, though. Don't make any mistake. The Germans are not sitting back on their laurels. They're sitting back nicely at the finish, but very quick onto the next catch, really working it through and not letting anything happen behind them at all. Certainly not going to give the other crews a chance coming up. Romania still in second position. The United States have come through strongly in to third position now and includes one member of the seventh place sweeper crew last year from Rajici, now in the quad. But look at the Dutch come and the Belarusian lineup. It's going to be very, very close to the medals now as we approach the catering area and the grandstand. Gold looks certain, but the battle really is on now, and what a battle for silver and bronze. The Romanians are still just up in front. The United States and the Netherlands, it's bow ball to bow ball stuff. Belarusian looking stronger and stronger after a slow start to this race. Four crews in contention for those two medals behind the Germans. Just a few last strokes. Germany's got gold. What's going to happen at the line for silver? The Dutch looking better and better. Will they get there ahead of Romania? It looks like it for me. And then Romania, I think, for bronze, just ahead of the United States. We'll hear it all in a moment. Gold for Deutschland. Eine fantastische Leistung. Hinter Ihnen wurde es dann ganz, ganz knapp.
Paul, thank you very much. Another thrilling finish. Let's confirm the medal positions for you. It's gold for Germany, it's silver for the Netherlands, and it's bronze for Romania. Gold Germany, silver Netherlands, bronze Romania. Germany, the world champions in the junior women's quadruple sculls. Fourth, the United States, Belarus fifth, and Italy sixth.
Maybe a reason why all the doors are closed, so you could open one that leads you to the perfect.